Okay, here's a question from Abraham in Los Angeles. It might sound like a simple question, maybe even a little humorous, but my feeling is this applies to many of us. So he says, I've been counting the Omer and focusing on the heat kalalut of the Sfirot, but this has not resulted in a more good heart within me. What am I doing incorrectly? So I said it's a little humorous, but it's so true. It's so true.
That we are, this is a moral lesson for all of us, each one in his way, that to say words and even to think thoughts is not necessarily going to change your character. It has to be more than that, more than just saying the words and more than just thinking the particular kavanah of each day. It requires serious labor. Avodah is labor. And labor involves sincere prayer. Sometimes it involves itkafya, which means identifying what your weak part is and forcing yourself, coercing yourself even to change your behavior patterns. And ultimately, it's in order to produce itapcha, to actually transform yourself altogether. But it's a laborious service of Hashem. It's not, don't think that just saying words and thinking thoughts in Hasidut, sometimes even there was much criticism to people who thought that they were Kabbalists and praying out of a Sidur of the Arizal, which has pages, page after page of names of God that you just have to think when you're saying the words of the prayers. So in Chabad, people that did that were just made fun of, as though it's almost like a farce. But you're turning the pages and looking at the letters and the words, and you think that you're doing something. But you're just fooling yourself because you're not doing anything. It's a famous story of the Maggid of Mezrich that he used to love daven at length. And he had a friend that he studied with, who also was a great Mekuban, who knew Kabbalah very well. And he came to his childhood friend, the Maggid of Mezrich, and he said to him, I think all of the Kabbalah of the Arizona, I daven much quicker than you. It doesn't take me so long. So he gave a whole parable, but the essence of the parable is that you just think the words. He says that it's a person like he has to do business in Leipzig. He has to travel to Leipzig to the market. So there's one person that stays at home and he just thinks, he visual, and now there's a concept of visualizing. He visualizes, this is also a farce to visual, sometimes just to visualize is a far, pure farce. He visualizes that I'm now going to Leipzig, I'm traveling on my horse and wagon to Leipzig. And then he thinks out the whole thing, the whole process, what he's going to do there in Leipzig. And he comes, it takes him only a half an hour, the whole trip. He says, that's the difference between you and me. You just think it out, I go there. He also goes there in his mind, but he's going there. So it's two different things altogether.